شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على نبينا الكريم. Ramadan Mubarak to each and every one of you. We pray to Allah Azza wa Jalla that up to this point you've been getting the most and the best out of Ramadan. We want to now mention the first thief that comes to us and they rob us of our reward and our efforts that we put forward through the month of Ramadan. And this is something that is specific for the most part to our sisters, and that is the suq or the marketplace. Allah Azza wa Jalla's Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam informed us, إِنَّ أَحَبَّ الْبِلَادِ لَلَّهِ مَسَاجِدُهَا وَأَبْغَدْ الْبِلَادِ لَلَّهِ أَسْوَاقُهَا. The most beloved places to Allah in the earth, on the earth, are the masjids. Allah loves the masjid because His dhikr is there, the salat is there, all of those issues that bring people close to Allah. The closest that a person is to Allah Azza wa Jalla is while he's in sajda. And it's called the masjid because it's the makan or the place of the sajda. And the worst place to Allah Azza wa Jalla are the aswaq, the marketplace. Because in the marketplaces, people are lying, people are cheating, people are screaming and behaving, and they're jipping one another, they're oppressing one another, they're swearing by Allah, and they're just lying and they're not being truthful. And all of the other munkarat that take place in the souq. So in the month of Ramadan in particular, we have to go to the marketplace, but really if a person were to be able to set it up and organize themselves where they didn't have to go to the marketplace throughout all of Ramadan, this is better for them. Because it's the worst place and the most disliked place on the face of the earth to Allah Azza wa Jalla because of all of the evil that goes on in that place. So I like to say to our sisters, all of them, and anyone else who has to go to the marketplace, the souq is a sadiq. The souq, the marketplace, will steal from your rewards. Because when a person goes to the souq without a minhaj, without remembering Allah in the month of Ramadan, in the spirit of Ramadan, then as I said, he's going to mix with the opposite sex. The person is going to look at that which is not permissible. The person is going to waste a lot of time even. So the time that he or she could be using to be home, reading the Quran, making the dhikr of Allah, or doing things that are more fruitful and productive in the marketplace, the individual is just jamming up his program. Now it's something that a person has to do. You have to go to the marketplace. I don't think anyone is going to be exempt from going to the marketplace for the most part. So now the question is, how do we go to the marketplace to get the most out of the marketplace so that it does not steal from the reward of Ramadan? First of all, I would advise that you make for yourself a list. You make for yourself a list. To this day, I have an aversion to the souq because I remember as a child, my mother, my sisters, we would go to the souq and my mother would do that window shopping. We're in the souq and she's not really looking for anything. She may have an idea of what she wants to buy, but while being there, she's wandering all over the place. And my brother and myself, we just used to complain and we wanted to sit down. And we used to always get in trouble. To this very day, because of that reason, I don't like going to the souq. And I think many men are like that. So as it relates to saving time on the day of going to the souq, make for yourself a list and have laser focus to just get there and make the tahqiqat of the aghrab that you want to get. Buy the things that you want to get. Another thing is a hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. There is a dua, the dua of the souq, that I would encourage you to memorize. Prophet Muhammad said Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, anyone who says this dua when he goes to the souq, he gets a tremendous reward. That dua is La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو الحي لا يموت بيد الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير. You go back and you look at that dua and you memorize it, because most of what's said in that dua, most of us already memorized it, but it's scattered here, scattered there. All you have to do is bring it together. The person who does this, Prophet Muhammad says Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Allah will raise him 1 million hasanat. 1 million hasanat. and Allah Ta'ala will wipe away from him 1 million sins, 1 million sayyi'at, and Allah will raise him 1 million degrees. Now, as it relates to the amana al-ilmiya, the trust of knowledge, the academic trust, I must say that some of the scholars of al-Islam, major scholars, they deemed and they said that this dua of the suq is not authentic. Some scholars said that. But other scholars said that it is authentic, that it is hasan. And I follow the opinion of those scholars who say that it is hasan. The other issue is, you know, our scholars of the past, like al-Imam Ahmed, the Imam of Ahlus Sunnah, rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, said when it came and when it comes to weak hadith, he was talking about himself and the ulama of al-hadith in the past, they said if the hadith was weak and it had to do with deeds of doing good, at-targhib wa tarhib, al-Imam Ahmed said, kunna tashaddadna. If the issue was dealing with aqidah, if it was dealing with the ahkam, halal and haram, they didn't take those weak hadith. They were serious about the weakness in the chain of narration. He said, but if the hadith was in the targhib and the tarhib, do this and do that, and it was weak, he said, tasahalna. We, the ulama of al-hadith, we became easier and a bit more gentle. So I'm of the people who believe with those scholars that the hadith is hasan, it is acceptable. But even if it is weak, it is in at-targhib wa tarhib. So we encourage you, inshallah azzawajal, to make that dua upon going to the suq and being cognizant and aware that the suq is a sariq that can steal from you the rewards of Ramadan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.